If you use Power BI, you need to add the new card visuals to your reports. They're now generally available, which means that you can finally make your report KPIs look top-notch professional. People are going to think you spent hours on this, but you just did a few clicks. Let me show you the best parts. Okay, so over here in my Power BI report, I'm going to add a new card because I want to showcase some KPIs on top of my report. That's the card. We're going to populate it with some data. I'm going to go ahead and add my total sales measure to this. Okay, let's just resize this. Now, this just looks like a plain standard card, except you can add multiple cards. So let's go ahead and add total quantity and total cost. And just like that, I've added multiple cards to this one single visual. Now let's go ahead and see what type of formatting options we have. So let's bring up the formatting options. The cool thing here is that you have so much control over design and context. Yes, you can add context to each of these KPIs because the numbers themselves don't really mean anything unless we compare it with something else. So we could look at sales as compared to previous year, sales compared to budget, and so on. But before we get there, let me just cover some of the most helpful features that I think you're going to need. The first thing you might notice is that you have a lot of options here, and this might feel overwhelming, but just think of this as a hierarchy. So size and style applies to the entire card. You can add a title to this whole thing if you want. Multi-card layout allows you to change the design if you're using multiple cards, like I am in this case. Cards adjust the design for the individual cards. Callout is the content of the cards, and you can add more information either through an image or reference labels, which adds more context for each KPI. So let's start off with size and style, and I'm going to take you through the most commonly used ones. Size and position allows you to control exactly what you want the height and width to be. In a lot of cases, you are probably just going to use your mouse and adjust the size as you need on your report. Padding allows you full control over the distance of this border that you see here to the edge of the card. So if I increase the padding of the top, notice this moved further down. So you have full control over the padding on each side. You can adjust the background, you can change the background color, you can turn it off. This way, it looks like we have multiple cards. I'm going to leave it off here. That's it for these settings for me. I'm going to close this off, right? It's good practice to close off this hierarchy so you can see where you are. I'm going to ignore the title in this case. Let's take a look at multi-card layout. So the style I have right now is tiles. I could adjust this to be a table. I could shift this to be vertical. Obviously, I would have to increase the size here. And I could adjust how many rows I want this to be, and if it's horizontal, how many columns. So if I reduce the columns to 2, I would need to scroll. Or I can just switch my arrangement to be a grid, in which case I can show everything in this view. Right, so we have full flexibility here. I'm going to put this back to horizontal tiles, and let's put our columns back as well. Now let's just collapse this and take a look at the cards. We can update the shape of each card. So instead of rectangle, let's go with a rounded rectangle. We could also adjust the corner radius. So if we don't want this big of a radius, I can just put this to 10. So notice the changes that I'm making apply to all the cards. That's because of this setting right here. If you want each individual card to be formatted differently, you can select it from here and then format it. What I recommend you do, though, is to do all the formatting that you need that applies for everything and then override individual cards with their own formatting. So I'm going to set this back to all. And let's remove the border for all. Let's update the background for all. You could remove it if you want to make it blend in better, but I'm just going to add it in and just change the color to a lighter color. I'll go with this one. I'll add an accent bar. This gives us a nice effect. You can switch the accent bar to be on the bottom or the top. I'll just keep it on the left. You can adjust the color and the width as well. Let's also add a shadow. I'll go with a darker color here and I'll leave these as is. But notice we cannot read our values. So let's go ahead and update the callouts. But just to keep things clean, let's just collapse the changes that we made to the cards and move on to the callouts. So again, the settings that I'm going to apply now is going to apply to everything. I want all the values to be a lot smaller so I can read them. So let's adjust it to 30. I want the labels to be smaller as well. I'm going to go with 10. And I'm going to switch the position of the labels from top to bottom. Okay, so let's just expand this a bit so we can read all the numbers. In addition to this, we can also add an image for the callouts. So if I leave this setting on all cards, whatever image I add is going to be added to all of them. But if I want cards to have different images, I can select the specific KPI first. So I'm going to go with total sales and then add an image for this one. So I'll just browse for it. Let's select the image and add it in. We can adjust how we want this image to be fit. Stretch, fill, and center. I'm just going to leave it on fit and change the position to be left of text. And I do want it a lot smaller, so I'm going to update the size to be 25%. Now comes the best part. This is where we're going to add context to the cards so we can understand the values better. So just for simplicity, so it's easier to follow, I'm going to get rid of cost and quantity, and we are just going to concentrate on total sales. Now, let me introduce you to reference labels. With this, we get to add more information to our card. So it would be good to know what the previous year sales were. So let's search for that. And it would also be good to add in the budget sales. That's right here. By default, they get added like this. Now we can adjust again the settings for all labels. So I'm going to leave this on all. And for value, I want to make these bold so they stand out. And for title, I'm going to make them a bit smaller. I'm going to go with 10. Now I would like to adjust budget sales to just say budget. So let's select budget sales only. Go to title, field name, custom. And just remove the sales bit. Now, let me set this back to all and add more detail to this. If I expand this right now, notice this part is grayed out. I get a message that this setting can't be applied to all labels at once. To use it, select an individual label to modify. Okay, so we need to add details to a specific label. So I'm gonna go and start with sales previous year. Now I can select, I'm going to add the variance. So let's do previous year change. Okay, so that's added right there. We can adjust the formatting of this. In fact, it would be nice to add some conditional formatting. So I'll click on this effects, change this to rules. My field is previous year sales percentage. If the value is less than zero, I want it to be this red. Add a new rule if it's greater or equal to zero and less than and equal to max. I want it to be this green and okay this. That's automatically added. In fact, let's expand this so everything is spread out nicely. Let's do the same thing for budget sales. The first thing, don't forget to switch your selection here to budget sales. Now for detail, I'm going to add the percentage change for budget. Let's also add conditional formatting to this. Select the field, change the color to red if it's less than zero, and again if it's greater than zero, let's change this to a green. Okay, so that's looking nice. I'm just not so fond of this design because it does look a bit crammed. So let's go and close this and take advantage of reference labels layout. Let's expand layout. For arrangement, switch to horizontal. I want the alignment to be in the middle here. Now it's easier to read. Now remember, if you had multiple cards, you can define if you want this setting to apply to all cards or if you want it to be different for each card. You have so many options to create beautifully designed reports. Now, if you're watching this and thinking, I want to build fully functioning reports, but I need to learn Power BI properly first, I have a full training program called Fast Track to Power BI that takes you from beginner to expert, and we keep it updated. Yes, it does take a lot of effort because Power BI changes a lot. Members tell me that they went from zero to leading Power BI projects at work. Now, if you're not ready yet to commit to a full program, there is a free preview that you can test drive first. Links are in the description. Now, going back to our card, I just want to mention that you're not restricted to this layout. If we go back to reference labels layout, you can turn off the background color here to make it blend in, or you can change the background color to whatever you like. If I also go back to cards, layout, I can adjust the order. So default order here is callout and then reference label, but I could bring the reference label first if I wanted to. We can also get rid of this divider. Here it is. I can turn it off or I can make it more subtle. So let me just go with this color. So many options to fit your needs. The cool thing is you can also add categories to your cards. So if you're wondering why these features are grayed out, well, you can use them if you add a category. This way you can create cards that look like this. Each set belongs to a category. Now, another neat feature is the hero image. With it, you can create cards like this, where the image is a separate object on the card. Let me show you quickly how to set this up from scratch. So here's my empty card. This time I want to add manager information for each of the different stores. So my value is going to be the manager name. Let's go and bring up our format options. Let's go to callout. Remember, the content of the card is the callout. I want to remove this label. It doesn't bring much value, so let's turn it off. Let's also update the font size so it's readable. I'm going to go with 20. Sometimes people have long names, so let's also enable text wrap. Okay, now I'm going to add the picture of each manager. Notice that we have an image option inside the callout, but that's not the one that I want to use because this is connected to the callout. I want it to be independent of the callout so I can adjust its position on the card. That's why I'm going to use the image option here. The pictures of the managers are a part of my data set. So I'm going to go with select from data. I have a field called manager picture that has the URL. For image fit, I'll adjust this to fill. Now, before we worry about formatting, let's also add a bit more information about the stores. I want to grab the city as well as the website. So let's go to reference labels, add data, add the store city, and the website. Okay, so we have all the information here. Let's improve the layout. Let's go to cards, layout. The current order is callout image and then the reference label. I'm going to go with callout, reference label, and image. To make these fit nicely, I'll go to collage and select reverse. This is better, but this bit can be improved. So let's go to reference labels and adjust the font size of all values to be a bit smaller. I'm going to go with 10. Let's also adjust the titles to be 10. Now, in fact, these titles don't really bring much value. So let's customize each of them. For the store city, expand title, go with custom. I'm just going to use an emoji here, Windows dot, and I'm going to go with this pen icon. Okay, so let's update the website text as well. Custom. And I'm going to go with this icon. This looks a lot neater. As you can see, with just a few clicks, we're able to create beautiful interactive cards. So that's it for the new card visual. Try it out. Let me know what you think in the comments. And I'll see you in the next one.